Hello, welcome to the Rise of Purple Phoenix, the Byzantium Empire Knight of Honor 2 campaign YouTube series. I am currently experimenting with this new style of video edit. If you find this style of gameplay highlight more enjoyable, feel free to click on the like button and leave a comment on your favorite moment of the video. Also, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon for more interesting content. Thank you. And I hope you like the video. Enjoy! Oh my god, the Mongols are coming. The France, as usual, is OP, as usual. Germany, yeah, basically HIE. Okay, I'm shrugging. That's unfortunate. Let's continue that. I mean, at least my city now is going very fast, so I think I'll build... What should I build? Should I build a church here? No, no, no. One. One, two, three, four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If I build a marketplace here, you allow me to train sword. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Emirate allowed me to get ship. Okay, so my capital region will build all this, as well as all my barracks. So there'll be 8 buildings reserved, 9 buildings. So the 10 building, I don't know what should I do. I think I can actually also do market square, since it will also increase my money and happiness in my capital region. Yeah, I'll do with this. Okay, so let's check my ledger. Okay, so basically my church province is now not happy. Why is it? Why are you guys not happy? Okay, the kingdom is not stable. Oh yeah, I forgot to... Okay, let's try to get enough gold before I increase the stability of my nation. Alright, so now I have enough gold. Let's increase my crown authority by 1. And now my stability of kingdom is now very stable. But the opinion is quite bad. Neighbors wants us to help them against France, while France is one of great power. Are you out of your mind? Who are you at war with? Who are you at war with? Genoa? Naples? What is this nation? Naples? I'll support you with my heart and mind. And unfortunately, I need to build up my economy first before I can help you. But I do support you in terms of spirit. Yeah, I'm supporting you spiritually. Okay. There you go. I hope you win the war and pray that you will survive this war. And good luck. Goodbye. Just like, basically, this is how geopolitics 101. Wait, France? No. France is actually really powerful. France is actually really powerful because they have the knights. They have the special unit knights, which they can actually curbstorm all the Iberia region as well as England if they want to. The only thing that keeps them in balance is the HIE, which most of the time they will break apart because they have too many royal marriages, and they will eventually be forced to give out lands to all their surrounding neighbors. And so the only reliable ally I have is Serbia and Hungary, and supposedly Serbia should be very, very weak. I support France with heart and mind. Good luck. yes. I support them with my heart and mind, but I'm not going to support them military. Yeah, basically geopolitics 101. Alright, let's continue the game. Why is the game stuck? Okay, let's continue the game. Alright, so the next building, I think I will build a barracks here. And later, royal armory. Is Austria strong? Austria is actually quite weak in this game. I mean, if you play games like EU4 or any Paradox game, Austria is supposed to be very powerful. But historically, that's wrong. The actual elector in Australia is actually belongs to a small province called Nitra. But eventually Nitra, he married the Austria prince and princess and become the Duke of Austria. And later they become the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. So yeah. So actually I like the concept of this game because he actually make Austria to be not that big and not that weak. Yeah, so basically this very historically somewhat accurate and not accurate. Since Austria is actually part of what religion, part of what culture, let me check. Germanic culture. Oh yeah. I forget they dumbed down the culture map, Bob. If I'm not wrong, their special unit is actually pikemen or light infantrymen, or the something like infantrymen, something like land based, something like walking infantry. Yeah. Oh yeah, the most OP unit I think is from this area where the cavalry is so cheap. They're pretty German but different strength. Yeah, the three common German language, right? The standard German and then Austrian German as well as Dutch German. Yeah, basically they're something like a different German, but they have a thicker accent. Their accent is quite thicker compared to standard German. Okay, let's continue the game. Alright, so now let's see. Okay, my clergy is very happy. This is good. Okay, so I think I can upgrade. Oh, hello, Duakram. Welcome to the stream. Oh yes. Today I'm starting a new campaign as Byzantium. We are going to do a full run and try to reestablish Byzantium as the sole hegemony in the Anatolian as well as Levantine area. I don't think I'll fight Mandux. Yeah. So I'll try to reestablish the glory of Byzantium in this region. So basically become the bulwark against the Arabian invasion. Arabic invasion. Yeah. And of course, this is just a game. This is just a game. I'm just trying to play this game. Please don't involve some weird stuff. Okay. Yeah, Revival of Byzantium, the Rise of Purple Phoenix. Anyone who played EU4 knows about this thing. Yeah. Basically, every history gamer will say, why not build more tanks? Then Germany will win World War II. But the fact is, we do not know what's actually happening during that era. So all we can do is speculate and try to tinker on what should they do. But in actuality, we do not know what's going on in that era. Yeah, basically, this allows us to fantasize on how we become a king. Yeah, I mean, almost every boy, there will be a period in our life, in almost every boy's life, where we imagine ourselves as a knight or adventurer, where we go out to have fun and go out to fight monsters and become a hero and become famous in our own adventure. Yeah, something like this. Maybe it sounds a bit too noble. Yeah. Okay, let's continue the game then. Okay, so I'm not currently saying go. Yes, good luck. And what someone said that the Ottoman has double manpower or something. Yeah, the Ottoman or Seljuks, they are actually quite powerful. They actually have about, like, look at this. They have four. Well, I only have, I have five because I actually expanded my city. The starting city is actually much stronger than the other city. But they're actually not that, this is actually manageable if you know what you're doing. And of course, some of the YouTuber that posted the video saying that the Ottoman is unstoppable. Well, nah, anyone who played this game know that it's possible to beat them, but just that you need to know how to do it. I think this new gen would love to become Isekai hero. Yeah. Basically something like anti-hero or the character in the Healer series. Yeah. Healer series. Healer series. I still can't believe they actually make the anime adaptation of the Hilda series. It's so cursed. Alright, so what building should I build next? So I'm reserving this 4 building and this 4 building. If I build a market square, I can get a gold. Yeah, I don't think I'll be building Royal Army because the last time I tried to rush a military building, right? I actually got cut stopped because even though you have very advanced unit, your unit will still die if they are just a recruit. So if the enemy has a level 4, level 1 archer, level 1 bowman, they will still beat your unit. Hold a minute, I have Varangian. Oh yeah, I forget about this. I have the Viking Varangian Guard as my special unit. Alright. So if this is the case, I will just build market square to get more gold. Yeah. And unfortunately, my king is a diplomat. I mean, it's not that bad. Alright, it's for a merchant. Hungry is trying to trade with us. Okay, this is good. So the next thing, I'll try to get another merchant. Or should I try to upgrade my merchant? Wait, why is this? Expansion. Oh yeah, I need to save gold for expansion. Alright, who cares? Let's do that later. Okay, so let's try to get... Okay, so you are now a governor of this city, right? So let's try to get this one to increase more gold. Bribery. I could get my base more trade income. Bargain. Produce good, but there's no goods produced here, right? Yeah, there's no goods produced. And eventually, it will be once the moment I build this 2 building, it will be at this 2 slot here, so I won't be able to get this in time. So I'll just get bribery then to get more gold. Logistic. Okay, so let's try to upgrade my district. Okay, I need 500 books as well. 200 gold. Okay, let's try to do this expand trade mission first. Once I get to, let's try to do this mission by saving up 200 gold. Alright, let's do this now. And let's check. Okay, so I need 500 gold for another merchant, which I think I will trade with Hungary, and later I will need to form an alliance with Hungary against Ottoman.